So I want to talk about something here, which I'll get to in just a second. But first, I want to do a quick pull. Not real fast. Just not gonna launch or anything. I'm just gonna roll out in first gear, and then there's a car right there. Let it get a little far ahead. But pull out. I'm gonna roll out in first gear. And then do the pull. And alright, now the reason that was, I know I shouldn't compare this car to front wheel drive I had at one point, but when I had my Eclipse I used to have back in 2009 through 2012 until it was totaled due to someone driving under the influence. But it's a little warm in here. But that car, if I would do the same thing, it would start roasting the tires all through the first and then part of second. This car, however, doesn't do that. Now I know it just different factors that would cause it not to spin like that. One of which is, I don't know, but they say it's supposed to have limited slip differential when I read. I guess we'll help with that. And plus, not to mention that the rear tires are 275s. The Eclipse had 225 all around. And I know that in front wheel drive cars, you get the guys like that, the front seems to get lighter because of the force. So that could also contribute as well. And because, you know, in a rear drive, it's wide. But that run was only like 4 miles per hour to 61. So, I just thought it was interesting. Like I said, I know you can't really compare two cars or two different beasts. I mean, the Eclipse was pretty beefy. They had the GT model, so it was the 263 horsepower, 263 torque. Whereas this one supposedly is 323 horsepower and 278 torque. So that's a road, of course, but it's a flywheel. that's all I'm going to do with this video. I just wanted to talk about that for a minute. Thanks for watching. You know, thanks for your time, and I hope you all have a blessed day.